Hello everyone, my name is Cameron Smilov. I am an Azerbaijani citizen. In my last video, I've been talking about the autocratic Azerbaijani government, enlightening you about the then current situation in the country, how Azerbaijani government's been harassing its own people. Today I'm going to be talking in more detail about this despotic regime, about its dictator Ilham Aliyev. If you've ever heard of Azerbaijan, I guess it must be a Eurovision Song Contest that Azerbaijan won in 2011. The country is rich with natural resources such as oil and gas. As of this moment, the country is being ruled by the Ilham Aliyev. Ilham Aliyev inherited his throne in 2003 from his father, then President Haydar Aliyev, by rigging election. Fed up with his father's despotic regime, Azerbaijani people, Azeri people, gathered in Freedom Square in front of the parliament building to protest, peacefully protest against the rigged election. But the newly self-elected government had no intention to let the people peacefully demonstrate, thus unleashing its so-called soldiers on unarmed civilians. Masked policemen in body armor made big runs into unarmed crowds of civilians. Shots were fired and water cannon used. Children were among those beaten, and one innocent child was killed in the clashes. That day the regime managed to hold its power via brutality and animosity. Nothing has changed ever since. The country is being ruled more or less in an Italian mafia style, where the two families, Aliyevs and Pashayevs, are in charge of everything. No one gets arrested or being framed or tortured or even killed without their say-so. Corruption is in every nook and cranny of the country, paralyzing everything from education, economy, healthcare, you name it. The lack of independent media and civil society secures impunity for corruption and other crimes. The ruling family and their lieutenants enrich themselves benefiting from corruption, while the ordinary people live in poverty. Kidnapping, beating, and framing journalists became a routine in Azerbaijan, let alone ordinary people. One of them is Khadija Ismail, a prominent journalist who was subjected to blackmail with sex tape filmed by secret services in her accommodation. Having refused to cooperate with the despotic regime, later on she got her jail time on a bogus charge. Another journalist is Afghan Mukhtarli, who was kidnapped in Georgia, the country that Azerbaijan shares borders with, and brought back to Azerbaijan, and then was sentenced to 6 years in prison on trumped up charges. Both journalists were released after spending some time behind bars. Afghan Mukhtarli was exiled from Azerbaijan, and Khadija Ismail, she's still being held as a hostage in her own country with no right to leave the country. The only reason why the government imposed such animosity on those journalists, because they were doing their jobs, investigating and exposing corruption, telling the truth. One of the regime's notorious tools to stifle and silence dissidents is fabricated drug-related charges. In 2016, two Azerbaijani activists, Gyas and Bayram, were sentenced to 10 years in prison in the same style, fabricated drug-related charges. But the real reason behind this was graffiti that they sprayed on a statue of a former president of Haydar Aliyev, aka the founding father of this regime. The regime is responsible for many crimes against Azerbaijani people, Azerbaijani citizens, poisoning and disabling their future. The sooner we get rid of greedy, power-thirsty dictators around the world, the better. If we want to accomplish this as humanity, as those who stand for democracy and don't take it for granted, must act together. The regime must be held to account by international community. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more videos on this channel made in Azerbaijan. Thank you.